started the Longhorn Relief Program approximately 2 years ago. The first one, we teamed up with the Campus Environmental Center. Right. I provide the tools and the expertise. The students essentially bring the muscle.
Pretty much our goal is just to beautify campus and make everything a little bit greener. Just treat Earth Day every day.
You know, students, you know, they go out, they conquer the world, and they have to come back years later and put a name on a building in order to leave their mark. For a few hours of blood, sweat, and tears, give students the opportunity to leave the mark on this campus longer than any building ever will.
Out here today, we're doing a basic plant sale of live plants and seeds, supporting the native species of Texas. Just spreading plants around campus.
I'm here today showing the Alley Flat Initiative, which is a project that combines social equity and green building. The Alley Initiative really is addressing low-income, long-term East Austin residents who are facing increased property values and therefore increased property taxes. And so they're actually being priced out of their houses. They can't afford to pay the taxes. Green building and low-income residents really go together nicely because it provides them with a way to lower their monthly bills. So this is a way for them to stay in East Austin neighborhoods.
One of the things we do to promote sustainable product and educate staff and students is hands-on cooking demonstrations. People know that we're going out of our way to try to fill a need.
Well, what we do primarily is public sculpture and installations that are environmentally themed. We've been working with Keep Austin Beautiful, and they've got a campaign right now that's dealing with plastic bags.
Oh, they're made of plastic bags.
Oh my God, that's cute.
The idea is to get rid of these plastic bags. Of course, you can crochet and weave the bags. You can make clothing, you can make cool artwork, make umbrellas, you can make all kinds of stuff. It's a fun material just to work with, and then also too, in doing that, you're recycling the bags.
For people who bring in two recyclables or more, we're giving away canvas tote bags and these nice little plants.
We're having people come up and write sustainability wishes, things that we can work on here, great things that we can do for UT to make us more green, and then you get a piece of cake.
Happy Earth Day!
The bus in the background is a hydrogen fuel cell plug-in hybrid. The bus has a fuel cell on board which uses the hydrogen to recharge the batteries while the bus is traveling down the road. The University of Texas at Austin is the site of the first hydrogen-fueled bus in Texas. The bigger part of the program isn't so much the bus, it's a hydrogen refueling station that we'll be installing out at the Pickle Research Campus. Consumers will eventually be able to use the station to refuel their own vehicles, which is also a first for Texas.
Austin is going to have a new commuter rail. It's going to go from downtown Convention Center all the way up to Leander. In terms of price for you, it's efficient for your wallet. You're only going to be spending the price for the train ticket instead of the gas. And instead of your time sitting there driving, you're going to be able to sit on the train with your computer using the Wi-Fi or reading a book.
I'm here from facilities, and a big aspect of what we're trying to do here is save energy. We're changing out compact fluorescents, occupancy sensors, so the lights can go off and on automatically so people leave lights on all night. Water-wise, we're reducing our water usage. Those are the kind of things that we're attacking.
University services is UT printing, UT copy centers, and UT mail. It's very important to consider where your paper is coming from. We want to make sure that we have environmentally friendly papers as a standard, and that's what we're doing. We're reducing our energy and providing sustainable materials, and we will continue to grow that.